Back to the Adam Carolla Show's Carolla Family Thanksgiving with clips and video at adamcarolla.com. And now, a very special musical performance from Adam's dad, Jim Carolla, on the Adam Carolla Show.
Hell yeah.
Good to see you, Pops.
Hi, good to see you.
Pull the microphone up to the super cooler there. All right, Dad, a couple of questions, and then we're going to get to a song. You brought your trumpet in. We're going to do a little scatting. First off, an observation I had just a second ago. I thought, you make a good old guy. You know, a lot of guys, when they get older...
He's got a point.
It's an interesting thing. Dad, tell me if you can identify with this at all.
My dad made a terrible old guy by dying.
My dad said to me the other day when I was arguing with him, he said, I'm old. I don't remember as many things as I used to remember. I don't move as fast
as I used to.
And I thought, that's fair. And then I thought, I never noticed you getting old because you didn't have a big transition. What I mean is, there's a lot of guys where you go, oh, man, so sad to see this guy. This guy was a lumberjack. This guy never stopped betting women. He was, you know, big, big man on campus, captain of the football team. And now look at him. A former shell of his former self, you know what I mean? You just slowly crept into old age, but I don't notice any difference in you.
Good.
Was he chattier once?
My dad has always been a kind of, ever since, I don't know at what point, maybe age 40 or something, but you've had a demeanor of a more mature man. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, there's nothing, here's what I'm saying. There's nothing you can't do now that you used to do, is there?
Well, physically, you mean?
Yeah.
Oh, no. I mean, there's things I can't do now, yes.
But what did you do when you were 40? Rugby? Do you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
Please, Brian. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but I'm telling you that there is a difference in balance and in...
Oh, yeah, your walks aren't as fast as they were. Mm-hmm.
Which,
but you know what I'm
God.
Saying? I mean, if your hobbies are reading, playing the horn, listening to jazz, going on walks, you can do that at 40 and you can do it at 80. It slows down a little.
Right.
Danny's not going to be able to do whatever Danny does now when Danny's 80. Thank God he'll never see
I'll
80.
Never see
right.
We talk about my death all the time and how young Amy will still be.
Yeah.
She'll get to enjoy my money at around 30.
No, I was just, I was thinking, you know, like when you, if you're into boxing and you like boxing, you can't box when you're 75 years old.
Reading is a lifetime sport.
But that's right.
Thank you very much for his quick
play
walk.
Play one game.
When I knew him, because his quick walk and that soft-spoken voice didn't sound a lot like that when he would run across the yard and go, hey, don't shoot Whitey. And I'd say, thank you, Mr. Carolla, and I'd go back to class.
My dad was one of Danny's teachers at the troubled school way back in the day in Agoura Hills.
It was after you'd been expelled from the troubled school that you ended up at this place.
This was the worst of the worst. So, Pops, you brought your trumpet. Quickly, it was asked earlier in the morning, and I didn't have an answer. How long were you married to Mom?
17 years.
17 years?
Oh, you were off by only what?
10 years, just a decade. I don't know. Dad, how long did it feel? Into the 70s or 80s?
How would I know that?
Who said that?
Oh.
That's your ex.
You don't know that voice?
How should I know?
Come on, you must have heard that a couple of dozen times in 17 years. Play the first one more time so I see my dad's face.
How would I know that?
She's not here, is she?
No.
How should I know?
No. My dad was about to do his first shoulder roll.
I knew she was a ghost.
You didn't think he could move fast?
He moves like a three-toed sloth until that. Now, all of a sudden, he's Ricochet Rabbit.
Before we hear your song.
17 years?
Yeah.
Holy Christ.
Now, does that include the separation?
Oh, no. You can't include that, right? You guys got separated, but you didn't get divorced for another 8 years or so?
About 4 or 5 years.
Four or five? Hold on, Dad. It was longer than 4 or 5. You're rounding down now, brother. Because you guys got divorced. How old was I when you guys separated? Do you remember that?
Oh, let's see. About 10.
10?
Approximately.
I'm a little off on my charts. I thought I was younger. I thought I was more 8, 9, and I thought you guys were separated for 7, 8 years.
I'm not exactly sure.
And why no divorce? Most people, like Danny's getting a divorce.
Right.
Why no divorce?
Well, neither one of us were going anywhere, or we didn't have many money in those days. And so we just lived our separate lives until something came up to do with
this. So when you guys separated, it was for good. You both knew it was for good, but no reason to do the paperwork and get the lawyers.
Something like that.
And did you just leave? I mean, you had a car, right?
Yeah.
But that's it, right?
That's about it, yeah.
You just got in your Volkswagen and drove?
No, I lived at the grandmom's house.
Now, whose mom would that be? Your mom?
No, your mom.
Your ex's mom. How was that?
I'm just picturing myself doing that because you were probably somewhere around the age I am now. And my mother-in-law passed away about 6 months ago. But I would take my car, point it toward the guard railing, just like the great Sammy Davis Jr. did, and hit the accelerator before I went and moved in into her house in Reseda. Dad, that must have been hellish for you.
No, actually it wasn't. I had a small room in their house for a short while. I was looking for a place, maybe a month or two.
Yeah.
And that's when I was working at that school where Danny attended.
Oh, really?
It was that period.
Is that when you screamed at him, "You think you got problems? I'm 42. I'm flat busted. I'm living with my in-laws in 900 square foot of North Hollywood. Okay, kid, cry me a effing river."
Danny Partridge is running around with a needle stuck in his arm.
You're 12. You can go to rehab 35 times before you get to where I'm at, kid. Get out of my face.
You win.
Mr. Corolla, did you drive here today in the Honda CRV, which is a great car, or the Jaguar that Adam leased you?
No, I'm here. I should say something about that for a moment.
I opened up a cranberry can of worms.
Well, I drove here in the Jaguar.
Yes.
But I've been really working on getting miles on it. I've measured my driveway. It's about 30 yards.
Right.
So I counted going up and back 73,000 times.
That'll get us up to the mileage, yeah, because I leased the car.
Oh, about 9 miles.
Okay.
Yeah, so we're still far behind.
So it's mostly driveway miles, but when we turn it in, it'll be up to the mileage of the lease.
But Adam, Pops made the adjustment.
I like that, Pops. All right, and Pops, let me ask you one more question. I was 17 years, really. Wow. And when it was after 17 years, just got in your car and drove over to your in-laws' house and rolled out your Bambi sleeping bag and called it a life.
Well, no, it wasn't that abrupt. It took a while.
But you had to save some money up to get your first apartment and everything?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No furniture, no checking account, savings account, T-bills. Bonds, anything to whack up at all? Was there anything that you guys split when you split?
The kids' college fund that you'd been...
Nothing? I mean, you didn't argue over a crock pot or something where you go like, hey, that was a gift and I got that before we were married. There was just left.
Yeah, it was a terrible time in the sense that I don't know if you remember this, Adam, but when you flew out to Menominee, Wisconsin. Well, there I go.
Nominate Wisconsin?
Menominee, Wisconsin. My dad was what you call an international playboy.
Yeah, life in the fast lane.
Cherry Hill, New Jersey, Menominee, Wisconsin.
Kenosha, Wisconsin.
He'd be the guy in the white smoking jacket. He'd say, give me my insurer, shaken, not stirred. And then we'd go to the mall. All right, sorry, Dad. Menominee, Wisconsin.
That was, I don't know if you know that, but that project was a project that could have made a lot of money for that person that I work with. When that went bad after about a year, all the investment made in that and time and money and so on. So when I came back to Los Angeles, from New York to Los Angeles, we were broke as a family, and the marriage was not well.
Was Menominee, Wisconsin, the house that had chamber pots?
No.
Wasn't that one. But there was a chamber potted house. There was a house that had chamber pots under the beds and an outhouse. I remember that clearly.
When you mean... Yeah, we had like a little cabin. Is that the part when you went to Wisconsin?
Yeah.
Because I was at the University of Wisconsin.
I was raised like a young Abe Lincoln.
What were you doing at the university?
Gay and depressed and about to get shot.
What was I doing at the university? I went there to study with a French anthropologist that found a way, this is a long, long story, but just let me give you a line, to read affect and almost know what a person's thinking. So he knew how to do it, and he had a little laboratory there where he taught foreign students and so on. And the company I work with, they really were interested in I being able to read affect.
Can you?
Yeah.
He can tell you think he's pathetic right now, by the way.
I don't.
How dare you?
What is Adam's affect saying?
What do you say? What do you see, Pops?
Crazy about your father. I see that in the meeting.
He said that to every single person that walked through the door.
No, but if you look at me, I am affectation central. This got to be pretty easy for a man of your stature and ability.
This could get uncomfortable.
Well, it's got to start game.
Don't pussyfoot.
Yeah, I have no feelings, or soul, or heart.
I do. It's got to take a sip of water.
Right. What do you think, Pops? Check out Danny and Teresa. What do you think? Do you have anything pop to mind? I know that was many years ago.
It was many years ago. It was different.
And did you learn successfully how to read people's affect?
I did for what it was at the time. It didn't turn out to be. It was more of a solo performance of this anthropologist. But I learned some of the aspects of it, and I did a lot of reading at the time. It's something I could always do a little bit.
Could you get a read off of Mom? Should I be worried about her bringing the pies on Thursday? Do you know what I'm talking about?
Is she going to bring the pies?
I'm worried a little about the pie.
How would I know that?
Should I be worried?
No, she'll bring the pies. That much she can
really?
Do.
She'll bring five pies from Marie Callender.
Hey,
yeah.
Bald Brian, play the thing three times. Let's see if my dad has a seizure.
How should I know? How would I know that? How can you possibly expect me to answer that?
I just read his affect.
Yeah, Dad? You all right?
What I did for the children.
That's right. There you go.
All right, we need to take a break. I'll tell you what we'll do. When we come back, Pops, you blow out your spit valve. I'm going to have a cup of coffee, and you're going to play your horn, and we'll do some live scatting on the air. Right. Back next, celebrating Thanksgiving a day early with Pops Corolla.
The Adam Carolla Show.
This is an amazing thing, and I ask you about these things, and what did you tell me?
Adam Carolla, Danny Bonaducci, and Teresa Strasser.
And all of them fine examples of California's gold.
The Adam Carolla Show.